These vintage Ritcheys are awesome. This bike is Matt's bike. Matt's a local school teacher who rides his bike regularly to school for work. He watched my Ritchey Ascent rebuild video and felt exactly the same way I did.
We're not changing anything here.
No.
If we can just take all this off together. The basket's held.
The basket's held on the rack with zip ties.
I have a special place in my heart for teachers. I struggled a lot with school when I was a kid, and some teachers really made a big difference for me.
Although it's tedious.
Yeah, no, it's quite all right.
Is it threaded?
I threaded it.
Self-tapping?
Yes. Yeah, just right.
Hey, it seems
this
to be...
This is the 11th hour of this commuter project. I was like kind of really trying to just like wing it.
I'll take this.
When Matt first found this Ritchey Ascent, his thought was just to get an old school mountain bike that he could ride as a commuter and not worry about whether someone stole it or did something to it. But once he first rode it, he fell in love with it, just like I did with mine. There's something really awesome about these vintage Ritcheys. So we decided together to do something similar to what I did with mine for his commuter bike. That's what this build is. A really basic rebuild using most of the same parts. Really just giving it a new facelift with a paint job and really a tune-up and rebuild of this awesome vintage Ritchey Ascent.
Turn 10.
Just 10? Because I need to stop.
It's also a lot of fun
bike stuff.
Doing the build at his house, getting to know his son who loves mountain biking also, and goes out often with his dad.
Everybody else in the bike
on other bikes,
right now,
not
like
this Ritchey. Alrighty.
Alright, cool.
Just go at it.
Sweet.
I recommend hitting corners and angles first.
Okay.
The primer, though, if it drips, we can sand it. While I cleaned up and prepped all the parts for the bike, Matt took his frame and actually sanded it down to the bare metal. This'll look good.
Yeah. It really was cool to see the craftsmanship on these.
Thank you.
Okay. Figured I'd tack these on first so it would.
Yeah.
Yeah. Got some other.
Alright, I think that's good.
So let's see if I put that in there real quick.
Yeah, I'll use your 8mm.
Oh, it doesn't even fit.
Will it not fit in there?
Okay. Maybe I'd fit that way.
I got it, actually. Here we go.
Okay.
Okay. Great.
Alrighty. That place that's not. Plenty of room, actually. So, that should be good. It's just kind of shoving the chain over and pulling it back, and that's probably just fine.
Oh, you gotta
pinch as it goes in. You have to kind of.
That's right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to, and then pinch them.
My son and I went and rode the bobsled this morning.
Oh yeah?
Pretty fun.
So Matt, thank you for letting me work on your bike. It was a lot of fun. I love how it turned out. Also, thank you for being a great teacher and making a difference in kids' lives. It's not an easy job, I know. For the rest of you, look for opportunities to give those old things new life. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next video. Ciao. We haven't been our best for love. A thing that we just hold. I also want to thank spray.bike again for the awesome paint. To be able to do awesome little paint jobs like this, just updating and changing a bike, really, it's amazing what it can do. Also, I'm grateful for Park Tools for being such a great partner and making it possible for me to do these kinds of things for people in my community.
Feels amazing.
I don't hear noises, so that's good. No creaking and squeaking.
I really like this bike. Matt let me ride it around too, and it was awesome.
Good.
What's happening right now?